Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm thrilled to be sharing an upgrade to my White's Tree Frog enclosure. So back probably almost a year ago now, I revealed my 90 gallon White's Tree Frog upgrade. It went from a 40 gallon ExoTerra to a 90 gallon custom All-American Cages enclosure. And now I'm keeping them in that enclosure, but I'm adding a background. The background is from Custom Reptile Habitats. I bought it, but I have been sent things free from Custom Reptile Habitats before. I've also purchased things from them before. I love the company, I love their products, their communication is great. So I have a link down below for them if you're interested. It is an affiliate link, which means that I will make a small commission at no extra cost to you. I'd say if you want like a zoo grade enclosure, it's the place to go. As you might remember, my White's Tree Frog Coco had some health issues that made me go from a bioactive to a more simplistic enclosure where I would have to take out the substrate. That is still the case, but they'll have a cool background, so I feel a little bit happier to be giving them that. So without further ado, I hope you enjoy.
Oh, I should not have made a noise. Oh god, Barry is already awake. Shoot. Oh man, I might have to have a snack ready for them then, because they're gonna go wild. Okay, be right back. Oh my god, look at him already turned around. Ugh, fine. So I have some Dubias ready because I know they're gonna be absolutely, oh, his mouth was open, I didn't catch it on camera. Yeah, okay. So they're gonna be wild, that's just how it goes. So they have this big front opening door. Hello already. Ah, oh my, 2 seconds into this video, Kiwi. Can you keep it together, please? Okay, I literally just fed them last night, but because they're gonna act out like this until I give them something, I'm gonna... Okay, see, this is unkind behavior. Right, unkind behavior. Sit still. Thank you. Well, it's a good thing I'm wearing a shirt because you can see my reflection, so... Okay, Durian. Oh my gosh, wait a minute, why am I so zoomed out? Kiwi, did you do this? Ah, don't fall. Okay, very good. Kiwi, good job. All right, Barry, since you're a little boy, you get a little one. Okay, let go. All right, let go. Yep, you don't gotta hang. Let go, please. What is this? Let go, fool. By the way, the White's Tree Frogs have their own tongs because they're so nasty and grubby and stuff. Oh, there you go. Okay, so everybody has had a snack, which means we should be good to go. There should be no more attacking of me or each other, okay? And you all were fed last night, so don't act like you're starving. Oh, hey, Barry. Ow, Barry. Sit still. Jesus. Okay, so these water bowls were literally changed at midnight last night, and they're not too bad, so I'm gonna record with them, but just know- I- Stop! Come on, guys. Stop it. Yeah, that's your brother, and he can't be consumed, so take a hike, Kiwi. Go on, up here. Take a hike. Barry? Don't go after your brother as some revenge, okay? We've all seen the plot to that movie. It doesn't go well for the smaller brother. I'm gonna start recording this video, and because I'm gonna move the camera around, I guarantee the frogs are going to, most likely this one up here, are going to attack the phone at some point in time, so don't be alarmed if you hear me go, ha, ah, and the phone moves. That's just Kiwi being a villain. So I tidied up this enclosure last night. It doesn't look like they messed it up too much, which is great. One thing that happens with these frogs and these vines is they knock them all over the place and the leaves get bent out of shape, but for the most part they're staying in place, so we're gonna record with it as is, and I hope that's okay with you all. One thing I want to say about this before we get started is that these white, hello Kiwi, these white bowls are likely not going to be a permanent fixture in the enclosure. I want to get some bowls that match the background. However, all right, hey, don't try to eat my wrist. Okay, I'm gonna get back to it, Kiwi. You contain yourself. So one thing I want to say is that these bowls, I want to get some that match the background, like they're made out of the same material. This thing won't even focus now because Kiwi got his slime all over it. But the reason that I would like to wait is because I have some other upgrades going on right now, and it's just like an expenditure that's not completely necessary for their like enrichment and well-being. So I'm gonna wait probably like a month or two to get them after I finish my other upgrades, because I feel like those are more important. So these bowls are not a permanent fixture, but they're doing the job, and they're plenty big enough for 4 frogs. This enclosure is a 48 by 18 by 24 All-American cages. It is made by All-American cages, and it was custom made from White's Tree Frogs with that mesh strip at the top, because my frogs are dumb and they give themselves nose rub like Mr. Barry here. Mr. Barry has a bit of nose rub if it would focus on him. They launch themselves at the top of their enclosure. They've done this in every enclosure they've been in. So when I had this one custom made, I was like, can we make the screen portion as small as possible so that they can get their UVB without having as much space to like scratch their nose on when they launch? And fortunately, over time it's gotten easier, but in the beginning they were really launching themselves at it. And this is their reintroduction back into the enclosure because I added a background. And fortunately, the only one who still has nose rub are Barry and Coco. And this is nose rub that's been healing for some time. So, can I put you down? Not near Kiwi though. Here, come sit up here. Thank you. Oh, and the reason that I use an enclosure that is not only like 24 inches tall, but also really wide, is because I don't know how this became a thing in the pet community that White's Tree Frogs are kept in something with a small base that's really tall. I mean, I'm sure that there's plenty of people who keep them successfully that way, but my frogs jump clear across this horizontally, not just vertically. Like, for example, when I leave this door open and I walk away, the frogs will jump out of this enclosure into the pet room, and it's like a good 8 feet from this to the other wall, or maybe even more, and they'll jump clear across that. So to give them something that's only 18 by 18 seems like it wouldn't be big enough to me. And so from the start, I've always kept them in something that was long and also a bit tall, because that's just what I think works better for them, but that's just my personal opinion. So if you're keeping them another way, that is okay. It's just my personal preference. Another thing about this enclosure is that it includes multiple inches from the floor to the door, because White's Tree Frogs are known to get nose rub by trying to crawl out of the glass from the floor of the enclosure, and they can't do that in this because there's no glass. They can't see anything. It's literally just the black enclosure. Boink, boink. So yeah, I wanted to avoid nose rub as much as I possibly could, so I had this you little psycho, come here, hang on to this. So I had this enclosure built to have a really high like front, so I could include some substrate, and so I could have as limited amount of nose rub as possible. Kiwi booty, kiwi booty, kiwi booty. Oh, it's not gonna focus on you because you keep jumping onto it and making the camera all foggy. So like I said, this is an All-American cages. It measures 48 by 18 by 24. And because the enclosure has this big middle piece in the middle of this like support bar, and it has this and it has that, I had to order the background in multiple pieces so that I could assemble it inside the enclosure, because one big wrap background wouldn't have fit in with this piece and wouldn't have been very easy to cut if in like, you know, make this work. So it's a little bit ugly with silicone, right? Just a little bit ugly with silicone in the corners and the tops. But if you look at it like this, you can't see any of that. So it doesn't really bother me too much, and I think it looks really cool. So this background is from Custom Reptile Habitats. It is one single sheet, another single sheet, and another single sheet. And then I installed it with silicone. Obviously the frogs were not in here, the enclosure wasn't in here, but I installed it with silicone. And then I also had these ledges, which came from Custom Reptile Habitats as well. In fact, when I ordered this background, they sent me this ledge. Oh, let's not come out my finger, please, Barry. They sent me this ledge near Barry for free, which is really, really nice of them. But I had these ledges already. Coco is like, I don't even care, I'm just gonna go back to sleep. But I had these ledges already, and I really love, because I wasn't planning on putting ledges in. I was planning on just having this flat background with like maybe a couple pieces, but I really love that I went with all of these like bigger ledges, because they really use them. Like, they like to perch on them, they soak up their UVB on them, they hide on them, they take a nap on them, as you can see Coco doing. So I'm really, really happy with that. This enclosure also features a bunch of manzanita driftwood. I get my manzanita driftwood from Manzanita Direct because I'm able to pick out the exact shape and size of pieces that I want, and it's a pretty good price if you don't count shipping. Unfortunately, shipping is not that cheap, but I really like being able to get Manzanita that's really big. It's really good quality. So I like being able to get it in like a bundle, and whenever I order from them, they always include a few extra branches. So anyway, that's why I just keep ordering from them. But there's tons of places to get Manzanita driftwood. The reason I like it is because it has a gorgeous color. It's got a nice smooth texture, so the frogs can't really hurt themselves on it. One thing I do recommend is that whenever you use Manzanita driftwood, you sand down any edges like this so that the frogs can't scratch themselves, because they are quite delicate. You know, they have soft skin. So just make sure that you sand down any edges of anything that you're using, whether it be driftwood or something resin or anything else. So because they are tree frogs and they like to perch and they like to climb, I have tons and tons of Manzanita driftwood around the enclosure, and it's just laid out in all kinds of ways, but I made sure that it was like secure, so when the frogs, especially this big one right here, launch themselves, they don't knock the driftwood out of place. So I was able to secure it into, you know, the background or along where the ledges are, able to like press it into each other so that it doesn't move around. Now, one thing that I do with all my other enclosures that I didn't get to do with this enclosure is go bioactive. And the reason for that is because Coco has some health issues that are kind of ongoing. They pop up every so often, and for that I need to have easiness of cleaning. And so I like to use sphagnum moss as a substrate. I know that a lot of people think that's controversial because they could accidentally eat the moss and swallow it and like choke or have impaction. I've seen this happen with paper towel. I've seen this happen with all kinds of things. So it is a risk for white tree frogs regardless. However, I don't feed mine on the floor of the enclosure. Oh, kiwi. Good frog. I don't feed mine on the floor of the enclosure, and I've never had an issue with it, and they've been on it for over a year. But yeah, like I said, the reason that I chose the sphagnum moss is because it's easy like to pick up and throw away. It's inexpensive to replace. And also it holds a decent amount of humidity, like around their bowls especially. And yeah, it's just like a nice, like a natural type of substrate. And I haven't had any issues with cleanliness because sphagnum moss is like antifungal, antibacterial. So yeah, I really like sphagnum moss. I know it's controversial, but I figured I would address why I use it. And, oh my god! Kiwi. Kiwi. I'm gonna need you to let go, my friend. I'm gonna need you to let go. How many times are you gonna do this to the camera, Kiwi? It wasn't focusing. I had your spittles all over it, you nasty. So anyways, back to the substrate. So I went with this instead of something like EcoEarth or Soil, which I think would be messier and also would be kind of harder to clean up, where sphagnum moss is like a big clump. And yeah, I've had success with it, so that's why I use it. Another thing about it not being bioactive is there's not live plants. And one big reason is because white tree frogs are kind of like destructive, especially my bigger ones like durian and kiwi. Like, because when Berry and Coco jump around, they're obviously not, you know, causing as much like devastation and destruction because they're so little. But these guys are big, especially kiwi, with how chaotic kiwi is. So if I were to have like a lot of live plants, I feel like they would poop all over them or destroy the leaves or like break them. And so having these fake ones is inexpensive. It looks nice, like it's well decorated. It still offers them plenty of like climbing and hiding enrichment. And so that's why I went with fake ones. I know that some people prefer like full live planted bioactives. That's my preference, but for my frogs and the situation I have, this is what I do. I wasn't even recording, but look, you can see. Do you see this? Ay, ay, ay. Pretty much nonstop kiwi. Boink, boink. Okay. Anyways, so let's do the final wrap up of the enclosure. So this is a 48 by 18 by 24 All American Cages custom enclosure with the screen top that allows UVB through. By the way, I forgot to say what UVB I'm using. Uh-oh, Barry sees my hand. So this is an Arcadia 6% T5HO UVB bulb, and now Barry's back to looking at me. Anyways, that's the bulb, and it is above a screen top. And then the enclosure, like I said, the measurements, it has sphagnum moss at the bottom, it has the Flukers pothos vines for the fake plants that has the custom reptile habitats background with all of the ledges. It has these water bowls, which I will probably replace with custom reptile habitats water dishes when I have the extra coin. Like I said, I want to put the rest of my money towards other upgrades right now that are just more important. And then it has all of these manzanita branches throughout. And the inhabitants of this tank are Kiwi, who I'm afraid is about to launch. That's Kiwi, that's Durian, and then we have Berry, and then we have Coco, who is still sleeping. Could not be bothered. Just totally vibing. I totally get it, Coco. But yeah, that's my White Street Frog enclosure. Let me know if you like it. Let me know how you keep your White Street Frogs down below. And I literally cleaned this door last night and it's already foggy again because White Street Frogs are nasty little creatures. Nasty!
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, let me know by leaving a like down below. Also, please comment. Please subscribe, hit the notification bell, all the good stuff. And with that, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!